Hi friends, in this video we're going to see about credit growth rates in India and how it will play out in the next few quarters. So below is a chart of India bank loan growth. So if you see this chart, so almost the loan growth in India has averaged between somewhere between 12 to 14% throughout. And even in the year 2013-14, it was somewhere around 18%, and it was much more than that before. But what has happened in the last few years is that the credit growth has almost come to a very drastic halt, like where again it's almost less than 6%. And this is also confirmed by RBI, where we are actually facing severe issues due to credit not increasing. And this has been consolidating for a few quarters by now, and this is the lowest that we have seen in almost multiple decades, like where credit growth used to be about 10% year on year, but now we are at low single digit, which is a trend that is counterintuitive, like where the number is at unevenly low number. But what I anticipate is that this number will go above 10% in the next 12 months to 24 months, right? Where credit growth has to take up. Like partly this reason was due to the fact that most of the companies, they were into deleveraging mode. Like they were actually paying off their debt, and also again, companies were cleaning up their balance sheet, where the BSE 500 companies' balance sheet is healthy, has become healthy over the last 5 years, and they have brought the debt level to a healthy number. Partly it has to do with that, and also again companies will now start to re-leverage if they see the demand again coming in, and also they will invest in capex, which will again initiate a re-leveraging cycle for the credit growth to happen. And this is a good trend to again watch out for, where banks, credit rating companies, and also few financial institutions, they might again hugely benefit with this re-leveraging cycles. And also again auto ancillaries, like they have also been underperforming over the last few years, and they might also perform well as well, like where historically auto ancillaries, they also tend to perform by a significant margin, but currently they are underperforming. So again, these are like contra signals where this trends could play out very well. So I want you to watch out for this credit growth and companies that will benefit due to this credit growth, where this can be a structural trend that might again play out in the next couple of years. So I hope you find this video. Feel free to subscribe to this channel and share it with your friends, whoever will find this video helpful. Yeah, thank you so much.